My name is Nathan Oliver, and this is Graydon Bader, and our project title is Impact of EVs on the Grid, EVs being electric vehicles. This project was performed with the help of Dayton Power and Light, my co-op. As electric vehicles continue to grow, there's obviously going to be an impact on the electrical grid, and the goal of this project was to determine how big that impact is going to be. So we worked alongside Dayton Power and Light using their modeling system of PSSE to calculate and research load data for each electric vehicle and hybrid in their charging stations to then plug that into PSSE and get a model to predict the impact.
So the way that we kind of started off the project is we wanted to get an accurate number of how many electric vehicles we think would be in the Dayton area in a projection of years out from the current date. So the way in which we attacked that problem was we looked at the U.S. trend of adoption of electric vehicles, and then we implemented that trend to a Dayton area size city. Using that information, we were able to then look at the type of electric chargers for electric vehicles and look at the amount of load that one of those chargers would put on the electric grid, and then implement that to the number that we would see increasing in that area. From there, we kind of took an approach on the rollout that we would see for electric vehicles. So we saw that as a small scale and a large scale rollout of electric vehicles in an area. The large scale was based off of the US trend, and then the small scale was a percentage of the US trend being added to the Dayton area.
So taking the projection of EV rollout, we looked at 7 different EVs and hybrids. We looked at the model Tesla Model S, Model 3, and Model X, and then we looked at the Nissan Leaf, the Toyota Prius, and the Chevy Volt. Those being the main heavy hitters on the U.S. market, those are some of the top-selling electric vehicles and hybrid vehicles that the U.S. has right now, with Tesla increasing every day. So plugging in those load values that we got, the KVA, the KW, and the KVAR, we plugged those values into PSSE, and that these were the graphs that were generated. So what you see here is a 25 bus IEEE sample case from PSSE. This is a model of the Dayton area. We couldn't use the Dayton region for security reasons, but this closely represents what the Dayton region would look like. It had about 3,000 KW for load. And with the projected load growth, you can see just how much it affects the area. So on a given day, on a normal day without electric vehicles, the system will operate like this. So dark red is what you want. It's ideal. These areas have high generation and they're funneling into the center of the system. And then with the load growth, it was about a 25% increase from 3,000. You can see just how the voltages tank in that area. So what you'll have happen in that area is load that's not sufficient for customers, flickering lights. They probably won't even be able to start a load of laundry, put dishes in the dishwasher. And then in the thermal plot, it's the exact same, but reverse. So the blue is what you want, everything running at a normal temperature. Then with the load growth, everything starts running hot. So what you're gonna have there are increased failure. So your transformers are gonna start failing over time. Their loss of life is going to increase significantly. So instead of getting 25 years out of a transmission transformer, you're probably gonna get about 5 to 7. And this is accurate with a quote we found that said, one electric vehicle is equivalent to 3 houses on the grid. Without this study, utilities they pretty much have their backs against the wall. They don't know what to expect. But performing a study like this, they can start projecting what could happen to their system and get a more accurate scope to where they could have their maintenance and scheduling planned for 2025 instead of having it surprise them in 2024 and have this hit in 2025. So it's better for a PR standpoint to where you can show your customers that you're investing into the future and that you're not going to be surprised when electric vehicles hit to where you might lose power. You'll be in a more advantageous stance to where you can provide power.